speaking today with John Upperman. He is Vice President of Procurement with Patheon Pharmaceuticals. John, welcome.
Thank you. It's good to be here.
Tell me a little bit about Patheon.
So Patheon Pharmaceuticals is a contract development and manufacturing organization for the pharmaceutical industry. So our customers are the big pharma organizations that you've typically heard of. So they do the formulation and we do the manufacturing for them.
Mm-hmm. Is this over the counter? Is it prescription? A combination of all that?
It's all the above, both generics and prescription.
Mm-hmm. So I assume at some point you guys had a wake-up call that kind of clued you into the need to up your game when it came to supply chain risk management, and maybe even use technology for that purpose. Talk about what caused that and a little bit about how you went forward from there.
Right. Now, that's a good question. I wouldn't say that it was a particular event. I've been with the company for roughly 2.5 years. I actually come out of 15 years in the technology space, where I feel that supply chains are more sophisticated. So bringing that experience into Patheon, I saw it as an opportunity for us to evolve and do better around risk management.
Mm-hmm. And what kind of risks do you really worry about the most in a supply chain? Physical, cyber, supplier problems? I mean, what is the keeping anyone up at night in this industry?
Yeah, the cyber question is a good one, and that's a more recent development, obviously. I wouldn't say that that's one that we've really focused on. But for us, since we are a supply chain services company, we have to make sure that we're able to perform for our customers. So I worry about the health of our supply chain and factory operations, disruptions because of fires, logistics disruptions, things of that nature that are going to prevent us from getting the raw materials that we need in order to do the finished dose manufacturing.
So what were some of the challenges that you encountered in the early stages of developing a program of this kind?
I would say that the biggest challenge is, particularly in our space, is getting the rest of the organization educated and aware and accepting of what it is that you're trying to do. Just helping people to understand the importance of it.
You would think that they would be already cognizant of that, and yet company after company tells me that that is the issue, that just getting everyone
right
on board with the notion of the importance of risk management. Why do you think that it hasn't been an issue up to now?
That's a really good question. I think that it has to be, unfortunately, something bad has to happen in order to get people to pay attention to it. But when things are going well and going smoothly, it's just difficult to help people understand that this is an area that needs focus and that it requires investment in helping people to understand that you want to be proactive as opposed to being reactive.
Yeah, and I think people have short memories too. Once a disaster happens,
right,
it'll be top of mind for a while, and then time goes by and it's like, well, did that really happen?
And it doesn't require a lot of time to go by. It's amazing how quickly people forget about those instances and
now
just kind of move on.
In order to measure risk, you have to have data.
Right.
Is the data there? How easy is it to get, and where does it come from?
Well, and that's the million-dollar question. So the data is there, but getting your arms wrapped around it and having the capabilities in place to actually look at that data. I mean, data is growing at such a rapid pace. Just your ability as an organization to be able to look at the data, aggregate it, analyze it, and then actually draw conclusions from it. That's the real challenge.
Mm-hmm. And of course, a lot of it has to come from suppliers. How cooperative are suppliers in providing the necessary data?
I would say that they are, for the most part, cooperative. And that level of cooperation is increasing because this is a conversation that's occurring across all industries amongst supply chain professionals. So they understand the importance of it. They're having those conversations with their suppliers as well. So I think that adaptability within the supply chain profession is increasing over time.
It's interesting because you're kind of in the middle of a supply chain. You have downstream customers.
Exactly.
And you have upstream suppliers that are necessary for your own manufacturing operation. So I'm just curious as to how everybody communicates with one another. Who's responsible for having that information in hand? Is it you on behalf of your customers, or do your customers, is it their responsibility to have multi-tier visibility? Where do you come in terms of providing that to them?
Well, it's a little bit of all the above. So we are starting to get those types of inquiries from our clients. They are looking at their supply chain and they want to ensure that they've got, you know, risk mitigated and that they have the appropriate continuity that they need. And to your point, we are essentially their tier one supplier. And so then we're going down deeper into the supply chain to their, what would be their tier two and tier three, in order to provide them that visibility.
How is it possible to assess benefits at this stage? I mean, can you in fact point to benefits that have been derived from this program already in areas like insurance or maybe you know, other types of cost-oriented type of concerns?
I think the biggest benefit that we've seen is that there have been instances where we have been notified of particular events that have enabled us to be more proactive or to react more quickly, I think is more appropriate. And you know, whenever you have an event that's big enough that it hits the news, you want to be able to have an assessment ready for your organization and give them the confidence that you've got the appropriate mitigation plans in place.
Mm-hmm. And I assume that your response strategies have to be coordinated upstream and downstream too.
Right, exactly.
I mean, what do you do there? Do you have like playbooks in place that are ready to be pulled down from the shelf the moment something happens and you're able to call in everyone at a moment's notice? Is it that smooth, do you think?
No, it's not that smooth. I think that's something that we aspire to, where we do have that type of playbook in place. Right now, it's somewhat reactive depending on the situation. But, you know, just having visibility to the information and being able to react to it quickly is a big improvement over where we were just a couple years ago.
Going forward in 2018, do you plan on doing anything different with respect to your supply chain risk management program compared with previous years?
Yeah, we're actually staffing a full-time position in 2018. So we are currently recruiting and interviewing so that we can bring somebody on full-time. And this will be their responsibility to not only further the strategy, but then help, you know, deploy the execution as well.
Yeah. So you've been through it now. You've got some experience at your back in implementing this program. What lessons might you have for the rest of us who are not at your level of achievement yet, for other companies who want to do this? Give me some advice that you would impart to them.
Well, I think more than anything is to network with your peers, figure out what they're doing. You know, you don't have to reinvent the wheel. There's people who are further along the journey than we are, and you know, I leverage those relationships to help hone my skill, and really just plugging into a community or a network of fellow supply chain professionals who are on a similar journey as you are, and tapping into that, you know, to that expertise.
Well, John, thank you so much for giving us a little bit of guidance on the path to better supply chain risk management and telling us a little bit of the story of Patheon, too. Thanks very much for being with us.
Thank you.
I have been speaking with John Upperman of Patheon Pharmaceuticals. Thank you very much for watching.